Lisa Swales at McDougal Elementary School in Klein Independent School District in Texas is another example of a teacher who utilizes technology extensively to provide hands-on and relevant opportunities for her students. That kind of instruction helps students develop a love and curiosity for science, which is so important for STEM education overall. STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math.
We are a Title I campus. In excess of 80% of our children are on the free or reduced lunch program, and technology is huge for our children. Many of them don't have the opportunities to have technology available to them at home like many other children do, so when they come to us, they are hungry.
When I introduced the lesson to the students today, I told them that they were going to be able to be meteorologists for the next few weeks because they would be watching the weather, making predictions, and finding out if their predictions were good or if they needed to keep watching for more patterns.
Have you ever been to Alaska?
No.
I've never been to Alaska. I've always wanted to go. We're going to go there
via webcam.
First we started and we looked at webcams of four different cities in the United States so that they could observe the weather that was actually happening right now at that time. And this brought that weather and that experience into the classroom for them so that they could see new things and experience all these wonderful adventures.
And you know, for a Title I population who maybe don't travel as much or have as many outside experiences, the technology brings it all to them. It's real.
We went first to Chicago, Illinois, where we saw the exterior of Wrigley Field. Then we took a trip to Anchorage, Alaska, and there were no people anywhere. Then we took a quick trip down to Miami, Florida, and they were able to see the sunshine and the palm trees of Miami. And then we came back to our own Houston and observed the weather here with the Houston webcams.
What do you see?
Light.
Do you see anything?
Shadows,
right? You can see shadows on the ground. So you know that the sun's shining at least a little bit. Somebody said they saw snow. Did you see snow on the ground?
Yeah.
So what does that tell you about the temperature if you see snow on the ground in Chicago, Illinois?
They were making predictions about what they thought the temperature would be, and we were looking for clues as to what the weather might be like in those cities at that time. Then, after the predictions were made, they went to the AccuWeather website and were able to actually find out and record what the temperature was, what the sky was like, the correct time for that city, and we're able to see if their predictions were correct or if they had been a little off or what they, you know, we're learning a little bit about making predictions.
Cool.
In order for the snow that was on the ground to melt, it has to be at least 33 degrees Fahrenheit. Look at the forecast. Will that snow melt tonight? When we use partners with laptops, we're able to put two kids together who one may be stronger using technology and the other one may not have as much experience. And so they're able to help each other and find new things together using the computers. When I want to enhance my lessons with technology, I use a lot of interactive websites that have simulations, things that the kids could do on a computer that they couldn't do in the classroom because we just plain don't have access to the materials that would be required to do that.
It's just made science a very real subject and not just something out of a book for kids.